Hey, what's up, everyone? I'm Justin, and here with me, of course,
Michael. What's going on?
He was with me for the movies video, and he's also going to be in a future entertainment road trip. But so, where are we going today? Let's see if you can remember how to pronounce it.
Camp Nabisco.
Camp Nabisco, yeah. Camp Nobibosco, where they filmed Friday the 13th, aka Camp Crystal Lake. And we're going to have a great time. Tons of filming locations, cool horror tidbits. I can't wait. Let's just go.
I'm on the far end of the couch. You must think I'm introverted, but I'm furthest from that. Can you see my teeth shatter from the nerves that I have? The fear of getting closer.
Welcome back, entertainment fans, for another tour of famous landmarks and locations. In keeping with our previous safety precautions, we're still going to travel somewhat local. We ventured out to northern New Jersey to learn what went on behind the scenes of the hit horror film Friday the 13th. This film revolves around a group of teenage camp counselors who get picked off one by one by an unknown killer, and all while attempting to reopen this abandoned summer camp. Now, the first town we're going to is where one of our main characters, Annie, searches for a way to get to Camp Crystal Lake. And that town is none other than Hope, New Jersey. The first stop in this little town brings us to Hope Junction Antiques. This small little shop has tons of knickknacks, including handmade Friday the 13th decorations. More importantly, though, it's where Annie asks for directions in the film.
Excuse me, how far is Camp Crystal Lake from here?
It's pretty clear this isn't a luncheonette anymore, but diehard fans can't miss this stop. It's also worth noting that outside, the sign reads Harding's Store. And in the movie, when they do the interior shots, you can see a sign with the same name on it. Besides the filming locations, there's some neat little things inside the shop that are definitely worth a look. As we move on and head down the street, literally two buildings away, we come to our next location. Currently, this building is an office for a realtor, but this storefront was used to introduce one of our more memorable characters in the film.
All the girls up there gonna look as good as you?
Not enough.
You're going to Camp Blood, ain't you?
God damn it, Ralph, get out of here. Go on, get! Leave people alone!
Crazy Ralph definitely made viewers feel uneasy early on in the film. Now, let's head to our last stop in Hope, New Jersey. Moravian Cemetery. Now I know, having a place like this as a tourist location is a bit odd, but believe it or not, me and Mike weren't the only ones here checking it out. This 200 plus year old cemetery still has the iconic gate standing in front of it, just like in the film. The whole town loves all the fans of Friday the 13th to come through, so you guys will have a great time. For the next spot we're checking out, it's just a few miles north of our previous locations. And the best part of all, we were here on Halloween. Blairstown, New Jersey. Yet another town that was used in the earlier portions of the film while Annie is walking through. Certain spots don't have exact numbered addresses, but don't worry, it's a small town. I'm sure you guys won't have any trouble finding these locations. Besides restaurants, historical landmarks, and filming locations, Main Street in Blairstown is home to the Friday the 13th Museum as well. Definitely check that out if you have the time. Before we leave though, we're going to head over to this town's last filming location. If you guys were unaware, I'm a huge sucker for anything retro, so an old-timey diner is right up my alley. Not only did a scene of the movie take place here, but the food is pretty decent too. I personally got the slash burger. Now I know I've been buttering you guys up, but before our main event, we gotta see those comparisons. And now, the moment you guys have been waiting for. Even though I went to this place years ago in Scouts, I'm looking at it in a whole new light now. Camp Nobibosco, the real filming location for Camp Crystal Lake. As you guys may have noticed, there was a ton of other people here when we went. That's because there's an actual tour organized for fans of the franchise, and let me tell you, it did not disappoint. Obviously, we have the filming locations, but to start things off, they have some fantastic photo ops waiting for you. We're going to be going through all the locations from when we visited last year. Most are still the same as you remember them on screen, but unfortunately over the years there has been a few structures that have just fallen apart or been the victim of erosion. Luckily though, the fine folks at Crystal Lake Tours have been restoring this place and it's never looked better. So let's just take it from the top. The River of Jordan is deep and wide. This area is unique for me, at least. The dining hall has a bunch of plaques of scout troops who've been there for camp. And wouldn't you know, I found my troop. Don't worry, I'm not going to stop all the time and chat about each location. There's a lot to see, so let's just keep it going. Those looking for the side-by-side image comparisons for the camp, don't worry, I'm saving them all for the end of the video. Because realistically, the camp is one big location. So for now, let's move on. For obvious reasons, the people at Crystal Lake Tours do not let you fire off any arrows. But regardless, it's really cool to see how they preserved this spot. As I was walking around this place, the childhood memories came flooding back. And just like any Boy Scout knows, you can't have a camp without cabins. As I mentioned earlier, some locations have changed in the past 40 years, including this one. As you can see, the wall next to where they killed the snake isn't there anymore. I think it's great though that Crystal Lake Tours has a fair amount of reference posters at each specific location too. Fun fact, as explained by one of the tour guides, this totem pole here was actually stolen, and later on, someone who had it in their college dorm finally gave it back to the camp.
I know what we can do. We're going to play Monopoly.
I hate Monopoly.
Not the way I play it, you know. We already rolled for you. You're going last, okay? And community chess cannot give you your clothes back.
The renovation on the main cabin is crazy. As you can see, the pantry Ralph creeped out of isn't even there anymore. This lodge is one of my favorite locations, seeing as a good chunk of the movie took place in here. Before we go any further, I think it's time to showcase the main event, Crystal Lake. The There's so many scenes that take place around this iconic location, from the killer skulking around to a beachfront final showdown, and hell, it's even the spot where Jason Voorhees is revealed for the first time. Now right here is where we saw that confrontation between Alice and Mrs. Voorhees. Since filming, the beach has receded back slightly. Regardless, being in this exact spot was a treat. Also worth noting that the original dock from the film has since been replaced now with longer lasting materials. Just on the edge of the beach, we come to Brenda's cabin, which is where Kevin Bacon's famous kill happens. It is real. At this point in the film, three characters get knocked off the killer's hit list. Jack and Ned right in this spot, and Marcy's is coming up next. The shower house. Originally known as Price Lodge, the crew decided to add on the showers and bathroom stuff just for the production of the film. Crystal Lake Tours has since tried to recreate that look just for us diehard fans. A few scenes take place here, but Marcy's demise is the most memorable moment.
Mike.
Being here in the fall definitely heightened the experience for me, being that it's so scenic. Now I think it's time to move on to our last few locations. This is just one of the few places where Alice travels when she's investigating the strange things going down at the camp. After all these years, I think it's cool that the powerhouse sign hanging on the shed is still somewhat intact. And just within a few seconds walking distance from here, we have our next little spot. Another quick scene towards the end of the film is when Alice tries to get ammo for her gun, until Mrs. Voorhees intervenes. Years later, this spot is noticeably different. It's pretty obvious they use this building currently for something, hence no windows on the garage doors. Our last location is a quick scene where Alice runs into this cabin and realizes the phone lines are cut. There we have it, everyone, mostly all the filming locations for Friday the 13th. But before we wrap this up, let's just compare our then and now shots. I can't wait to go back to this camp again, especially at night. Once again, we come to the end of another entertainment road trip. This one took a little longer than expected to put out, but don't worry, I've already filmed a few that'll be coming out next year. As always, thanks for watching, everyone. Until next time.